Hey everyone, welcome to From the Depths. I'm Minty, and this is episode 9 of the Frigate Fracas tournament. In this episode, we've got the Danupia Akizo, which is my ship in the tournament, which is a fairly basic looking ship. I wish I was better at aesthetics. And I also wish I didn't run out of materials when it came time to build the aesthetic stuff, but you know, such is life. She's armed with pretty heavy cram cannons, at least in my opinion, pretty heavy, for this tournament anyway. Hey, Harness. 63mm Seawiz that fires 307 RPM, and then the 8 deep water slash keelbuster slash just bottom-hitting torpedoes. Armor's pretty tough. I don't know if it's going to be tough enough to stand up to Red October's hefty, high-explosive barrage, but we will see in a moment here, won't we? I think this battle may very well come down to whether the Danupia can withstand these, like, 15, no, 18 high-explosive shells that's going to come flying at her right in the start. If she gets crippled by those, it's all over. If she survives, redone torp cables. Oh, the new graphic for them, right? I don't actually know if that update's... Has that update actually come out? I didn't look. For a second there, I was like, wait, you mean my torps aren't going to work anymore? But then I was like, wait, well, you're just talking about the... How they don't look like just a thin black line. Anyway. Go ahead and get this battle underway. So this initial volley, I think, is going to be quite critical. Oof. I mean, that is just the sloped blocks of the Danupia's armor getting blown off there. And Danupia's frags, crams. Yeah, look at that. I already took out a gun. A single barrel of one of the guns, anyway. Oh, yeah, those are the new torp cables. They do look a little bit better, yeah. Oof, oof, ow, ouch, ow, ow. Okay. Oh, okay. Danupia withstood that barrage, that initial barrage. Now she's got a good chunk of time to get some damage in without, you know, getting shot back at. Ooh, the armor on my... Yeah, it's blasted in. You can actually see APS components from the Seawiz gun there. Didn't quite get to the components, but it did make a hole to them. We've got the torps coming in from behind and underneath, hitting the side of the Red October. That one hit the underside. And Danupia has maneuvered its way behind Red October. Ooh, that cram shot didn't... Looks like it killed some barrels, and that's about it. I'm not sure where that hit. I didn't have the camera in the right spot. But Danupia's in a really good position right now. Red October can't put most of its guns on her. Another cram shot out. Oh, look at all that confetti from that cram hit. Oh, cram cannon took a hit there from Red October, but the armor really didn't care. Oh, and there goes the Seawiz. Ouch. Oh, it was time fused? Is that why it didn't care? It didn't take a direct hit? Gotcha. That Seawiz cannon getting blown up, though, is a lot of HP lost, which is unfortunate. For me, anyway. Oh, the Red October just lost its ammunition, though. It has zero materials. It only has like one ammunition storage, and that's all of its material storage. I believe it's right in here. I remember that about this ship because I was a bit concerned about that when I saw it. I was like, if that gets blown up, you're screwed. So yeah, the guns will get to fire one more time if they were already loading. If they already had the shell in there, I mean. Oh, and Dunipya switched broadsides. It has broadside switching at 80% HP. Not that that matters now that the Red October is not really going to be able to fire back much. Oh man, that was a big hit. All that confetti, those crams getting shoved straight up the stern of the Red October. Torpedoes getting in there, making some holes. Dunipya's still behind in HP, though. That APS gun getting detonated was quite detrimental. Oh, and if you're wondering how, if it has no materials, how its propellers are still going, it actually has batteries with electric engines. So it actually doesn't use materials for propulsion at all. There we go. That is the end of round one. Dunipya Gizo barely managing to pull off a victory there. No DQ points? Nope. So 78.6 to 76.8. It's a close first round. I was a bit worried about how well Dunipya would be able to withstand that rather powerful Alpha Strike. But she seems to do all right. Oh, straight into the superstructure. I mean, I couldn't ask for a better spot to be hit. And this first barrage, if it can hit a gun, that would be great. Yeah, like that. Hitting that gun. I don't know if any of those barrels are going to be operable anymore. At least one of them is definitely disabled. Dunipya getting hammered again, and right in this shoulder. That's probably the weakest spot on Dunipya's armor, and Red October is just pounding at it in the beginning. But now she's getting around behind again. A lot of those guns can't even aim at her anymore. Oh, got some anti-missile action going on. Cram out. That's gonna be a side hit. That's a decent chunk of confetti knocked off. More superstructure hits on the Dunipya. That's fine. Go ahead. Oh, that shots were going straight for that turret. I don't think it got one of the barrels. But I think they actually hit a little bit below. A little distraction missiles seem to be doing their job against the little bit of missiles that the Red October has. Oh, she has gotten broadside again, though. Oh, one of those guns, that's a pretty nasty hit. Lots of barrels missing from those guns. Oh man, maybe I should have had to nip you do its broadside switching a little earlier. That armor is looking pretty messed up. Oh, and the SeaWiz just got detonated again. What the heck is going on with that? I have never seen the Nipia Gizo do that before. She's taken off. Oh, switched broadsides. Presenting her stronger armor. I've done a lot of combat testing with this vehicle, never seen that particular thing happen. Good shot to the turret there. Yep, the flare is gone, and so is my SeaWiz. So, no more missile protection, but those missiles aren't terribly deadly anyway, honestly. But it is something. And every little bit can count when in a battle this close. Those torpedoes are definitely helping out. I'm really surprised that Dunipia hasn't managed to knock any guns off of the Red October. I thought that would be its kind of Achilles heel, but that's just not happening. Yeah, see, even that direct hit. Yeah, there is a good chunk of heavy armor in there. You are right. All right, and that's the end of round two. Dnipya losing that one. That's a 70.6. And 75.4. The torps won't pop a gun because these guns are mounted on the deck. Like, the entire gun is above the deck. So the torps will almost never pop one of those guns. It's basically up to the cram cannon to pull that off. And Dunipia turns that fast by. She just has nine rudders. She doesn't even have nine, does she? Just seven. She's just short. This initial volley again. I'm pretty sure I don't have any internal rudders. But I could. I could be forgetting, but I'm pretty sure that's not true. An extra thick. She is pretty thick. Her armor is holding up as well as can be expected against that kind of barrage. I mean, you're basically getting a nice little slice of what her armor looks like right there. Now, what I'd really like to see is for her to stay in this position. Well, not this position, but behind the Red October, where it can't really shoot at her as much. Ooh. Those are a couple of dangerous hits. I mean, the turret's pretty well armored as well, but those shells hurt. They do lots of boom. Distraction missile out. Ooh, that was a solid hit to that turret. Oh, it looks like that one was disabled. Ooh, that was almost a really good shot to the side of that turret. That would have probably been pretty nasty. This time the APS gun isn't looking so close to destruction, though. Oh, SeaWiz getting some anti-missile action on there. More torpedoes hitting. That's in the general area. I'm not entirely sure. I think it's like in the center of the ship is where the ammo is on this. I forget. Oh yeah, those missiles are proving no challenge for Dunipia's SeaWiz. Oh, she's getting around behind it. It's a good place to be. I mean, I don't know if I'd call that a flaw necessarily, Mitch. It's bad that this gun kept getting blown off, but wow, I'm not even sure the Red October has any functional weapons left. Like, oh, this one's got two barrels at least. This one's got a couple barrels too. Yep, there they are. But it has lost a lot of its guns. Oh, you're talking about losing one of my turrets. Yeah, well, that's true, I suppose. That is what's happening. Yeah, I guess I should have set the broadside switching up at a lower HP than 80%. Because at 80%, one side is basically dead. Like, there's nothing left of that armor. What kind of shot was that, Dunipia? You're supposed to shoot the turrets, not shoot between the turrets. And that is the end of round three. So it's 81.7 for the Dunipia and 78 for the Red October. Which gives us, wow, a really close score. Dunipia at 77, Red October at 76.7. That was an extremely close battle. The vote is going to be extremely red lovers versus green lovers. I mean, I suppose. It's like, man, yeah, I got absolutely hammered. To have that much damage and still, like, be functioning as if she was at 100% health, basically. Like, I'm pretty impressed with her sturdiness. Like, to have that much damage and just not care, basically. Yeah, my ship looks bad. I'm not gonna lie. It definitely does. But yeah, thanks for watching, folks. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.